As we always do on our preview shows, we ranked all these guys in the preseason here without conference affiliation, no East, no West. We're just doing straight 14 through 1. We're going to break this down for you, why we have all these teams in their places, tell you how each team can do better and put the best players available for each of these teams and talk about it. Number 6, South Carolina. Moving on to our number 5 team, Vanderbilt. They kind of feel a lot like every Vanderbilt team ever, built on pitching and just enough offense here. AJ, I'm going to let you talk on this Vanderbilt team. I know that there's a lot of pitching and a lot of things to like. One thing I want to mention before I send it over to you, Sawyer Hawks coming from Air Force. No, he's not Paul Skeens, but he is a good transfer in, a right-handed pitcher. But I'm going to go ahead and let you start off with this Vanderbilt team.
I mean, it seems like every year I look at Vanderbilt and I'm like, okay, this has to be the year where they're losing a ton of guys, and they do. Like, Enrique Bradfield Jr. is no longer there, and Parker Nolan transfers out. And it's like, okay, where are the guys who they leaned on? They're gone. And then you look at some of the guys they have returning, and it's like, okay, there's something there. You know, they have the talent. They have the freshman who throws 99, and they have the returners who can hold them in games. And then you look up in – the middle of March and you're like, okay, this is a very good team. It's like every year they're just gonna find talent. There's just so much reliance on youth this year with the freshmen that I think they're gonna do very well getting about 2 postseason time. My question is, during the latter half of SEC play and into the postseason, do the freshmen's bodies hold up? It's so hard for guys coming into the SEC for the first year maintaining that level of fitness. We see it time and time again. Freshmen lose stuff, freshmen lose velo, they lose power, they get hurt. They're going to rely a lot on freshmen.
Yeah.
Deservedly so, with the talent that they're bringing in the freshman class. I just don't know if they hold up. They're going to be dangerous. The talent's going to be there to jump up and grab you. But that's my question mark with Vanderbilt.
Yeah, you know, the weekend rotation is pretty well set, I think, with Holton and Futrell and Hawks now. So they're pretty well set up on what they're going to do. But they're going to have to rely on 5 freshman arms out of the bullpen trying to get some outs there in the SEC. And like you said, 30 games is a lot, and that's just the SEC play. That doesn't even match up with all the rest of inside. You're talking about 60 games before you even get to postseason play. It's a lot on these bodies, especially when these guys, mostly, you know, in high school, they're playing 26 to 32 games in a high school season. It's a lot of a different ability there. And then you come more like your first step to pro ball here when you jump into this college ranking, especially at the SEC level. Returning hitters, RJ Austin and Jonathan Bastien, give them a lot of opportunities to win ball games. I think that this is going to be a pitching and defense team a lot like what we're talking about with Kentucky. But they do have enough offense to make enough noise there to be ranked number 5 in our poll here. Number 5,